Hello, my name is Paige. I will be showing you how to create a graph from an Excel spreadsheet. Right now, I have Excel open with my spreadsheet already made. This is a basic spreadsheet containing information on school fundraisers. Even though we can tell a lot just by looking at the numbers, a few graphs might make it much easier for us to interpret and make decisions about the success of different fundraisers. For this set of information, we could use a bar, column, or pie chart because they are very easy to view and show comparisons. However, you will need to decide what you want to portray in your graph. First, I will show you the column chart. It is best to use a column chart when you are looking to compare information. In this case, you might want to compare how each grade did on cookie dough, magazines, and wrapping paper all at once. In order to do this, you would select the top row of the spreadsheet from A1 down to G5 by clicking and dragging. Once selected, go over to the Charts tab. If there is no tab displayed, go up to the toolbar and click the Gallery button. A variety of graph types will be displayed. You can scroll through them to see which type best fits the data and what you are trying to show through your graph. But in this case, select the column graph type, and then select the first one. This graph allows you to see each fundraiser and each grade level on the same graph. I am just going to move it down so we can view the spreadsheet and the graph all at once. You have the option to add a title. You can go to the formatting palette, and under chart options, you can add a title. If the formatting palette isn't already up, go up to the toolbar and click on the toolbox icon at the top. For this chart in particular, I would name it Comparison of Grades and Amount Raised per Fundraiser. Adding a title to both the X and Y axis is easy. You go back to the formatting palette, and instead of choosing chart title, you will choose horizontal and vertical axis to add titles. For example, for this chart, I will name the X axis grades and the Y axis dollars raised. This graph places the grades on the x-axis so you can easily compare the fundraisers in each grade. However, if you would rather compare how each grade did within each fundraiser as a whole, you can go over to the formatting palette and go to the chart data section. Right underneath that, you can choose how you want to sort it. Right now, it is horizontal, but if you choose the vertical option, it will do what you are looking for. Because of this switch, each fundraiser is clearly shown. As shown through changing between vertical and horizontal, you can get two different views of the same information without creating a new graph. Now, if you would like to show different information from the spreadsheet, you can create different types of graphs. If you wanted to show the total amount of money raised per grade, you would highlight each grade, then each of their totals. You have to do this by clicking and dragging over K through 5th. Then hold down the Command key, which is left of the spacebar, and click and drag over the totals from cell B5 through G5. These cells represent the total amount of money raised per grade level from the three fundraisers. After this, you will have your information selected. Once it is all selected, go to the tab titled Charts. Find the pie chart selection and select the first option. It creates the graph right there for you. If you would like to make it clearer, you can add the exact value of each piece of the pie. You do this by going over to the formatting palette. Under Chart Options, there is a drop-down menu titled Labels. There you can see the different options. The first is value. If you click on that, you will see that it adds the amount raised to the section of the pie it pertains to. If you choose percent, it will add the percentage raised to each piece of the pie. If you choose category name, it will label what each piece of the pie represents. As you can see in this example, you do not need the legend because the information in the legend is included by the pie piece, and so it would be redundant. To get rid of the legend on the right-hand side, go to the formatting palette to the drop-down menu titled Legend and click None. The last option for labeling the pie chart is category name and percents. This is a great option because it is clear what grade level it is and the percentage of the total that the grade raised. To add a title, you go to the formatting palette and under chart options, you can add a title. For this one in particular, I would name it Fundraising Totals Per Grade Level. Now your chart is complete and ready to use.